You know, you're doing a great job, but you're not using all your assets. With a body like that, you can go places.
Sexual harassment makes you feel like less of a person. For help and hotline numbers, ask for the Stop Sexual Harassment booklet at your public library.
Be a little more sexy. Hey, talking about your job here.
No, we're talking about sexual harassment here, and I don't have to take it.
Sexual harassment violates you, and it violates the law.
She sounds like bitch.
It's about business.
Hey, how can you tell when a woman means business? Who cares?
This month's closing, I'm
going to
need
a
visual.
Oh, we know what you need, honey.
Sexual harassment makes you feel like less of a person. For help and hotlines, read the Stop Sexual Harassment booklet at your library.
It was only a joke.
No, it's been going on too long. It's called sexual harassment, and it has to stop.
Sexual harassment violates you, and it violates the law.
The punishment for spanking another kid in school used to be detention, but a middle school in Oregon has taken it to a new level by calling in the cops and arresting kids for an infraction that used to be handled by the school. John Stossel has more.
Did you hear about the young sexual harassers? These two boys were charged with 5 counts of felony sex abuse in the first degree because of what they did at this Oregon middle school. Officer Marshall Roach testified about what the boys did to some 13-year-old girls.
I remember her telling us that her buttocks was spanked.
And in Waco, Texas, school officials say Chris Blackwell engaged in inappropriate sexual contact and or sexual harassment. His father was upset to learn that his son had
been wrote up for sexual harassment.
The school put it in writing.
Chris rubbed his face in the chest of a female employee.
The odd thing is, Chris is only 5 years old. He was 4 at the time of the alleged sexual harassment.
Show Mom how to teach you this.
What he did that got him into trouble, says his father, was what he's demonstrating on his mom here. He gave his teacher a hug. Only after Chris's father complained did the school agree to change Chris's record from sexual harassment to inappropriate conduct. At least Chris wasn't sent to jail, as were Corey Mashburn and Ryan Cornelison. Corey's mom got the terrible phone call.
He had been touching some girls, and we needed to get down to the juvenile detention. They were arresting him.
She and her husband rushed to this jail.
They said, well, we can tell you Corey is here, but you cannot see him or talk to him.
I was so scared I was throwing up the first and second night.
Why were the boys in jail?
It was butt-slapping day.
And what's that?
I don't know, that's just where everyone goes around slapping other people's butts.
The teacher told us to stop, and we stopped, and she took us to the office.
Why were you slapping girls?
It was just a game we did. You'd slap somebody, they'd slap another person. If you got slapped, then you'd slap somebody else.
Today, the girls who were the so-called victims of the felony sex abuse don't consider themselves victims. These two demonstrated what the boys and the girls did. At school, they say this was a regular event.
Every Friday we would have slap butt day, and pretty much you just go around slapping people's butt.
Both the girls and the boys were doing the butt slapping on butt slapping day. But as you can see, only the two boys were prosecuted. Why? Because they're easy targets. No feminist organization or women's groups are going to come to the aid of the boys like they would if they had done this to the girls.